Hey, maayong hapon kana tong tanan. Medyo taod-taod tang nawa, no? Kunwai na ningil na ko nga, sir. A new video na sir, sir. So, murag nakalimot ko post og lain, no? So, I have to introduce a new topic, no? This afternoon, no? So, ato din mga bagong subscriber, salamat ninyo, no? Sa mga nakatultol na diri sa wa pa makatultol, sige, tudloin ninyo. If you think nga what we did is worthy for you to share and to subscribe. The new topic na akong introduce is the thin-walled cylinder. Now, so, when can we say that a cylinder is a thin-walled cylinder? This is the condition. The wall thickness of which is 1/10 of its radius or even less. Now, so, that is the time we can consider that the cylinder is thin-walled. So, a tank or pipe carrying a fluid under pressure is subjected to a tensile force, that is, resisting worsting force. They are developed across the longitudinal and transverse section. So, if we have to sew, no, by cutting our cylinder, no, so, panalitan, this is our cutting section. So, if we have to cut the cylinder that manner, no, so, we were able to show the longitudinal section. So there are forces acting on it like F. We also have T. So your F is the bursting. It's a bursting force. No? So muna itong bursting force. Nga kanang imong T, muna itong mga resisting force. Now we have two types of stresses to develop inside our container or our vessel. So we have the tangential stress. No? So, doon natin formula magamit. Kine. Then, tangential stress is also termed as circumferential stress, hop stress, or a girth stress. So, why tangential? Because ang ato garong force, diha, so, is tangential to the surface of the cylinder. So, when there's a formula there, so, pwede na nato madiritso gamit. Pero, mas maayo siguro, atong tanawon, asa ang formula nagikan? Okay, so, let us consider its derivation. So, this is, again, the same section when it is cut, no? So, you're able to see the longitudinal section. So, there are forces actually develop here to resist the force due to fluid pressure. So, gini. No? So, the forces develop here, no? Ganang mga forces diha. So, gini ding imong T is the resultant of that resisting force, no? So, gini, we also have T here. So, that is the resultant of the resisting force that is developed on this resisting area. So, what is F? It is the bursting force due to fluid pressure. Your TDI is the internal resisting force. D, ganina in our formula, ang atong D is the diameter of our cylinder, this one. Length of the cylinder, which is this one, and the thickness. Okay? So, when can we say it is a thin wall? So, it is a thin wall if the thickness is 1/10 of the radius of the cylinder or even less. That is considered to be a thin-walled cylinder. Okay, so how to derive the formula? Now, if we consider the condition for equilibrium, no? So, ang atong F, no? Balances with, that is being balanced with the resisting force, which is T. So, our F is equal to 2T, no? So, that is our equation. Okay? Now, what is F? If F is the bursting force, no? So, it is a product of the pressure inside the tank. Now, so we have a pressure there. Now, so pressure then times the area. Gine. So pressure, so over what area? So ang atong area, gine, area is D times L. Now, that one. Now, so we have D times L. Okay, so ang ato karong resisting force, so imong tan-aw, what is the allowable stress? Stress times the area. Okay, so stress times the area. So, asa mo ng area na to? The area is, kini ato resisting area. So, it is length times the thickness. On say thickness? Ana? So, muna ito gibutang de. And if I'm going to go back to the formula, to the equation I meant above, no? So, pwede na ito napulihan atong F, no? So, F is equal to on sa rho with dl. So, pressure times the area at which the pressure is acting, which is kini. Then, 2 times, ansa? Kini? This is your T times L, no? So, which is the T is equal to twice, no? Duha man din ato ang t dere. So that is twice the t above, no? So this is the stress times the area, resisting area. So when that is simplified, no? So kanang imong L pwede ra na ma-eliminated, no? So if that is removed, so wala na L. So we can arrive with the stress nga gusto nato i-derive. So mahabilin na is the rho and d, then over the denominator, which is as a tau t. So that defines your tangential stress, no? By formula, so muna itong ipagita ganina. Okay? So magalimutas formula, then try to recall the manner how this formula is derived, no? Tangential stress is also referred to as a circumferential stress, Hope stress, or a girth stress. Now another kind of stress is the longitudinal stress. And again, just like the tangential stress ganina, we also have the formula that if we want to use it directly, pwede na sa nato magamit. Okay, so this is the, by the way, the figure here, actually pareho raman ini. So gani, naalan niya siya, gatakilid lang niya itong pagkat, no? Gana, so nag-atubang sa babaw, no? Okay, now, in the longitudinal stress, ang kalahian lang atong denominator of which is 40. Dito speak as on saman, 30. Abita. What is the other denominator? Ganina? The denominator there is 30. This time that is 40. So asa may mas dako ini ron? Katong ganina or kini? Actually, if your denominator is much bigger, so this is lesser compared to the previous, which is the tangential. Again, so we have pressure, internal fluid pressure, or the pressure inside the container. Your D refers to the diameter. And then you have a wall thickness. Now, the unit for your stress will be the same as the unit in your pressure. And if that is the case, so, kaning duha, kinahanglan pareho ng unit para ma-eliminated. And what is left? Kung sa unit, there is a stress mo, sa unit, sa imuhang pressure. Okay? Now, if there is an external pressure, so we take it as piece of O or rows of O. So, internal minus the, saan niya, outside pressure. So, the net of which, may multiply D. Do the same with the longitudinal. So, the longitudinal, bumahay niya, no? Ito ba itong ipagitang derivation sa itong unsa? Sa ito ang tangential. So, we miss you also how it is derived, no? So, yung ini. When it is cut, no? So, makita ni mo, huh? The stresses are developed, direct. Okay, so these are the forces that is resisting your F, this one. So, kining imong piece of T, no? So, mao na imong internal resisting force, which is its resultant, no? So, the piece of T and your F, no? Actually, they are equal to have an equilibrium condition. Observe, no? Now, what is your F? The bursting force. The bursting force is equal to pressure times the area. But your pressure is now acting on a circular section. Kine? That is why, if you have rho, it is multiplied with the area in a circle. So, we have pi d squared over 4. Okay? So, that is your bursting force. And your resisting force, so stress, then area, or the resisting area. So, stress times the, resisting area. So, the resisting area can be, pwede approximate lang because this is thin-walled. So, it is pi d. Pi d refers to the circumference. Circumference times the thickness. No? So, actually, so why I say it is only a product of approximation? Because the accurate area can be, pwede magamaguhag area defined by the outside diameter subtracted with the area defined by the inside diameter. No? Pero since the thickness is very thin, no, so pwede rin nato i-consider nga kaya siya circumference times thickness. So, the value obtained for the area out from that is much closer to the accurate value. Now, to proceed with the derivation, so gining equation, akong pulihan ini. Okay, singa na. So, when that is substituted, no, so sa ito niya, this is your F, and our F is this one. Okay, so there I have, na. Kanya, ang ako ang piece of T is now replaced with that one. And I can remove my pi common on both sides of the equation while my D squared is reduced after removing or dividing with D. So sa inhabilin, we have rho and d, and you have 4 times t. That is the longitudinal stress. Okay? Now, observing the two formulas, no? Kung natin tanaan, the value of the longitudinal stress is half of the tangential stress. So what does it mean? When the pressure in the tank is raised to a bursting force, no? Kung ang imo kunong pressure imuhang pasakaon ug maayo, ang atong failure will occur on the longitudinal section or longitudinal stem of the tank, no? So ang atong longitudinal is least stress, no? Okay, gamay ra man ang stress ma-produce ini, in fact it is only half of the tangential. So if there is a failure to occur in the container, so the failure will be reflected or manifested, na? So ana na siya diha mabuak, na? Ana diha ang fracture, na? So more critical ang sa tangential than the longitudinal. So the breaking of your cylinder will appear diri. Kana kon masubraan na ang iyang stress capacity. Okay, due to increase, it is the pressure inside the tank. Now, as an example, na, so you are given a problem here. Na, so, a cylindrical pressure vessel is fabricated from a steel plates with a thickness of 25 mm. The diameter of the pressure vessel is 600 mm and its length is 3 meters. Pwede ka mag-draw sa imong figure. Sa what I did, wala lang ako gidraw, but I simply collect the given. So this refers to T, pila 25 mm. I have a diameter of pila 600 mm. By the way, if the problem will mention diameter without mentioning outside or inside diameter, so just take the diameter as inside diameter directly. So these are the given from the problem. So the required ay, no? So gipangayuan ka kung saan. So gipangayuan ay, determine the maximum internal pressure which can be applied if the stress and the steel is limited to this. Now what will happen if the pressure is increased until the vessel will burst, no? So you are asked to sketch the type of fracture occurring in the cylinder. A solution, so what I did is to collect the given, no? Ako lang i-collect. Okay, so thickness, ganina, you recall? That's 25 mm. It mentions a diameter. I take it as the inside diameter of pila, 600 mm. What's the radius for this? If that is D equal to 600 mm, the radius of that is 300. So, kana kung ako i-multiply og 10 to 50 lang. So, that is less than the 1/10 part of the inside radius. So, it is really a thin-walled cylinder. In letter A, gipangayuan tagon sa pressure, no? Pressure ba? Yung sa pag-state ganina. So, determine the maximum internal pressure which can be applied if the stress and the steel is limited to 140 megapascal. Okay, so it is the maximum internal pressure, no? Now, sketch the type of fracture to occur. Okay, so in letter A, no? You can determine the pressure by considering tangential and maybe longitudinal, na? Okay, so when I have to consider tangential, then simply substitute the formula. The allowable for the tangential stress is 140. So I have 140 megapascal. Then my diameter is pilang. My diameter is 600 mm. So it's good that my thickness is also expressed in a unit of mm. Because as I've said, kung unsa units akong stress, mo sanay ako magamit as a unit for my pressure. So this is out. Then, pressure is now, by calculation, you will arrive with 11.67 megapascal. Then, you also have to check what would be the maximum pressure if the longitudinal stress is considered. Now, so okay. So, for the longitudinal stress, nyara din. So there we have the formula. So stress and akalain eh ang imo lang denominator nga 40. Since your divisor is 40, ha. Okay, so dito speak us, so ang imong pressure ana pwede siya ma pasaka pa. No, kun ari kas longitudinal. So it carries more on sa internal pressure, kung ang atong basihan nga stress is longitudinal. So sa ato pang longitudinal stress is dili critical. So ang critical na adere. So unsa may imong gamiton nga pressure, duha man ni ka possible values. So make use of this, because kung kini mo yung maximum nya kani imong gamiton, and that is applied to both tangential and longitudinal, so do nay unsa mahitabo nga unsa ma-exceed, ma it will go beyond the allowable, which is the 140 megapascal stress. Now, so this is not good for the cylinder. So the value nga imong gamiton is the one which is coming from the tangential. But kung ato lang tatong nahinumduman ganina, no, in our notice yon nga ang critical na sa tangential, so I don't need to solve for the pressure out from the longitudinal, considering nga unsa ang ato ang tangential mangyud mo imo govern on this case, no, considering that the stresses allowable for the tangential and longitudinal are the same. Okay, so what will happen if we increase the pressure until the vessel will burst, no? So this is now the condition or the problem in letter B. Increasing the pressure until the vessel will burst. Then sketch the type of fracture. So increasing the pressure, so it will say, produce a fracture there. So ana siya diya mabuak, because ang atong unsa, ang atong usa to critical, ang critical na to is the tangential. Sana siya diya mag fracture. So walay delikado diri nga part. Okay? So that is problem number one. Now there are instances wherein ang atong cylinder is made of pleats. Okay, ngayon eh? Where there is what we call as longitudinal joint and a girth joint. The girth joint is also termed as the circumferential joint. Asa mo na nato makita? Ngayon eh? This is when the tank is composed of two sets riveted together as shown in the figure. Ngayon eh? So, ngayon eh? So, imo nang butangan o rivets diya. This is termed as the longitudinal joint. So ang longitudinal joint mo'y mukari sa imuhang tangential. Kining imong girth joint or your circumferential joint is the one which will carry the longitudinal stress. Are dere. Okay? So if that's the case, ato to i-recall nga when the pressure in the tank is raised to a bursting point, failure will occur where? Ato siya mo occur along the longitudinal section, no? Adto siya mo occur, so sa ato pa are dere, na? So dapat kini mo imong ligunon og maayo kay dili man kay critical dere, di ba? Okay, so another condition to observe: the strength in the longitudinal joint must be twice the strength. So imong dublihon kung unsay strength dere, imong dublihon para dere for them to carry the same permissible internal pressure. Kay kon kini sila parihog strength diha, o mauna gini og kaguba. No, so in order to avoid that one, no, nga dili ni siya mauna og kalaksi dere, so it would be good that the strength in your longitudinal joint must be made twice, no? Imong dublihon ang strength sa imong girth joint para mukari sila og the same internal pressure nga dili maguna-una ang pikas og joint og ka guba. Okay? Now if the longitudinal joint dili makaabot anang dublihon ni mga unsa ang imong strength on the girth joint, so ang imong maximum pressure, the permissible internal pressure, will depend on the longitudinal joint. Okay? So that's the basic to in the thin-walled cylinder. Okay? So, ato lang sa sigurong putlon ko tubli ha. So, sa di pa ko malimot, gipahinumduman mo ko ganina sa ato ang bagong subscriber na, nga sir, asa naman ang sunod na tong video kay gahulat me, no? So, timing raba po kayo nga birthday niya, no? So, ako lang pong ingnon nga money akong binirdihan ni Modong, no? So, happy birthday ni Jenry, Carl Jenry Humula, no? akong estudyante sa CIT, o kung wa paon ta mapostpone siguro ang board exam karong May, no? So nanimaho na ni siya nga licensed civil engineer. So good luck ni mo dong o sa imuha ang coming board exam. And also advance happy birthday to my sis and hinatilan Cebu, say Ma'am Marianne de la Victoria, who will be celebrating her birthday this coming July 7. Okay, so hangtod sunod na to nga or sa continuation with a thin walled cylinder with more examples. Okay, so thank you for watching.